another edition of Pittsburgh Sports Line at Sips Sports Bar, 3024 West Liberty Avenue, 15216. We appreciate everybody here watching the show. We've got a great crowd here. This is the night before New Year's Eve. So this will be our last show of this year at Sips Sports Bar. We want to thank Sips Sports Bar and all the people involved. On a sad note, Smoking Jim's going to miss the show. He's in the hospital right now, and he said he's feeling great, but he's still in there since this past Friday. And he's in our prayers, and I'd like all of you on Facebook or whatever, if you see him, send some prayers to him and tell him you're thinking about him and get out soon. Although on a good note, the nurses want to keep him, so I don't know what that's about. Well, on our show, we normally talk sports and interview people, so we're not going to change that format. I'm Al Levine, the talking machine. I got Zach Little Z Brenner with Z Time is going to be early time, filling in for Smoking Jim Frazier. And we got Chip the Prophet Hainer ready to fill any of the dead time that we might have tonight. So he's already told me, and we're going to go with that. And last week, we were lucky Dave Cable, the director, come in on his day off and posted our last show there. So this show may not be on the air till next week. And if you tried to watch us Tuesday through Saturday, like I keep telling everybody, 7 o'clock till 8 p.m., the holiday events and performances from Bethel Park High School sort of preempted a lot of that stuff. So you will see all of our shows at other odd times and 7 o'clock to 8 o'clock on Verizon 32, Comcast 7 only in Bethel Park. And then we have a web page that's on Facebook called Pittsburgh Sports Line on Facebook. We hit 2,079 before I left the house, so thank you for doing all those likes. Anybody in the bar who hasn't liked us, I'd like to try to hit 2,080 before we get out of here, so I'm optimistic. It's easy to find us. We have a great site. We're getting between 400 and 1,000 people every day, and it's some of the stuff we post and some of the great interactions, so we'll keep doing that Pittsburgh Sports Line on Facebook. It's been a great year. And for some reason, they have a tradition that whenever I say the words I just did.
What was that?
Pittsburgh Sports Line on Facebook.
One more time?
No, I can't. We're going to move on. We do what's on our mind, and we're going to do that right now. Chip the Prophet Hainer, what's on your mind?
Well, thank you, Alan. And as this year is winding down to a close, 2013 is almost in the books. First thing I want to do is I want to congratulate my friend Alan Levine on winning Producer of the Year at the banquet last weekend. 2 years in a row. I'm very, very proud to be part of his crew, and lots more success. And we'll see if we can get a three-peat for you this year, Alan.
to interrupt, if we do 149 shows again, I know I got a lot of competitors out there. I don't think they can touch us. So thanks again, Chip.
All right.
Zach, everybody involved in it. Appreciate it. But, Aaron, Devin, John.
But, what's on my mind is what an amazing year for Pittsburgh sports this was. You know, you had the Pittsburgh Pirates that came back from the dead after 21 years of losing, not making the playoffs. They brought the fan base back alive. And, really looking forward to the 2014 baseball season. The Pittsburgh Penguins, after being swept out of the playoffs in May last year, have rebounded and are one of the top teams in the NHL, probably one of the odds-on favorites to win the Stanley Cup this year. And the Pittsburgh Steelers, what about the Pittsburgh Steelers? You know, they started off the year at 0-4, and the outcry from all of the Pittsburgh fans was fire the coach, and fire the coordinators, and fire the Rooneys, and fire everybody else. But, you know, the Steelers really did pull off an amazing feat this season. After starting off the year 0-4, they won 8 of their last 12 games. And they ended up the season 8-8. And unfortunately, because of factors beyond their control, they didn't make the playoffs. But I couldn't be more proud of being a Steeler fan than I am right now. And, one thing I do have to say is that Tomlin's not going anywhere. Todd Haley's not going anywhere. Dick LeBeau's not going anywhere. And the Steelers are going to go back to the playoffs next year. That's what's on my mind, Alan.
Chip, that was fantastic. One of your better, most optimistic rants that I've heard. What a way to end 2013 with a bang.
I'll say.
I thought my black and gold blood was gone, but that was the transfusion I was looking for. Go everybody in Pittsburgh. Oh, I'll rant in a little bit. Zach Brenner, what's on your mind?
Well, Al Levine, the talking machine. Nah, what's on my mind? I want to give a shout out to Jim Frazier, whose seat I currently occupy tonight. Hopefully we'll have you back after the new year. Sorry to anybody, I don't really talk as loud as my counterpart. But he did send me a little gift, a little belated Christmas gift from Jim Frazier.
Hold on, let me verify that.
That I'd like to share with you folks.
Hey, John, we need like a 190%. Check that. I'm going to fingerprint that.
Yeah, don't put his address on TV.
His name.
That's my address, Steph. Thanks.
Whoa. Hold it. Brenner Contracting. Wait a second.
It's just a picture of Jim Frazier, Steph. It just says Jim Frazier with a picture.
Yeah, we wouldn't reveal where he lives.
He's in God's country. That's all you need to know.
He doesn't need anything more.
You need help.
So
you're ticking.
Jim Frazier, the first book that Jim Frazier ever wrote, he sent to me from the hospital bed, and it says, Zach, get some exercise.
Hold it, let me see that. I'll hold it while you talk there, Sonny.
Is that spelled correctly?
It's spelled correctly, and he even got me on there, a little Brenner, got the Sportsline logo. So this is the first actual book that Jim Frazier ever published or wrote, and I'm honored that it has to do with me and getting some exercise while he's in the hospital bed laying there. I wish you the speedy recovery, Jim Frazier, and I can't wait till you get back and we can put your 225-pound bench press reps to the test.
He will beat you. He will beat you, I guarantee it.
But that's what's on my mind, folks. This is original literature from Jim Frazier. Get well, buddy.
You know what? I'm going to read this right now. It's just not pictures.
I have no control over what's inside.
Zach, get some exercise. Zach, here's my harem. Now, this is unscripted. Oh, wait, I got to throw that one away. Okay. All right.
Oh, you said harem, not hair.
Yeah. Zach, don't sit in the chair like I do watching TV eating Kentucky Fried Chicken. No, that was Burger King. I'm sorry. Hold it. He's using somebody else's name. We got to shut this down. I'm not mad. That's for Brenner. Here, this is a lot of pressure. Hey, thanks, Zach.
Fair enough.
Contact him.
Thank Jim Frazier.
Whatever his address.
Thank you.
Get well soon, my friend.
We'll see you in 2014.
And I hope this gets posted immediately on YouTube. And if not, Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. Did we hit 2080 yet?
81. There
no
we go.
No way. Whoever's here, I think we got two new fans that are right here in the bar.
I think it's Brandy with an IE in the back.
No, that's not her real name. She goes by something else. That's just her bartender name. Because it was I before.
Rats.
Except,
well, no pun intended. No pun intended here. What's on my mind is, everybody knows I'm a big sports fan in Pittsburgh. I do bleed black and gold. But when you have the easiest schedule that you've had in years, then you have a problem. And we did have injuries, but I'm so proud of the team to have a last half 6-2. And if you want to play what if, they really should have gone 8-0. So you wouldn't have to worry about referees, who I did post on Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook, that you have to realize that people cannot be that dumb. They have to be gamblers. Think about it. They're not getting in trouble for betting large sums of money on the teams that should win the game. They're able to make these calls and get away with it, and they have all of us, wow, they hate the Steelers. Well, why does it keep affecting us? Why does it affect point spreads? Just research that for a couple minutes. Why Goodell's not on that is beyond me. And look what happened when they had, what were those referees that they called in off the street? Now I hear excuses, these guys have great jobs and everything else. They're competent people, they've written books that are published. and they can't go by the rule books on each play. How does that happen? And then why does it happen to our Steelers? Well, that's my rant on the Steelers. I'm positive about the Penguins like Chip. I believe they can go all the way. Look at what they've done with the Penguins Wilkes-Barre team. Unbelievable with their record. Aren't they like the second best record in the league?
Yes.
I mean, that's just unbelievable. I'm hopeful with the Pirates because they're confident that they have good players. I feel they need a couple more to bring in there, not rent-a players, but a couple others. We'll talk about that when we do predictions for what's going to happen next year. But again, thanks for watching the show. Thanks for your compliments, Chip and everybody else. I want to give a shout out to Devin Shea, Aaron Ward, John the Tiger Tiger, and his mother gets an assist for the great cookies that Mary made last week. I looked around and they were all gone. I only had three of them. Now, I had four of them, but then they were all gone. And then a special thanks to Ann Tempest, Mario Tempest's mother, 90 years old, and we're still eating cookies at the Levine household. So it's a shock. So you know she made a lot of them because we've been working on that, me and my son here. And that's what's on my mind. And we're going to bring up our first guest starting right now. Welcome to the show.
Thanks, Coach.
Tell all your fans I brought you out of the bullpen. I'm glad that you beat your brother here. You and your mother were waiting here for a half an hour for the guys filling in.
Anywhere.
Really?
Even if he's there early, we still beat him.
Well, before we get into this family feud here, tell the folks who you are, because some of them didn't watch your last appearance, and I want them to know who you are, buddy.
Well, I'm a sophomore on the show. My name is Addison Brenner. I'm younger brother to Zach, who needs his exercise, apparently. But I'm already on the routine. This is my second trip on the show. I want to say I'm a little disappointed.
What happened?
The Panthers didn't get any talk yet. You know.
I understand. Well, you got to go to Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook.
Okay.
Because I also documented that the women's basketball team has won and they're doing well.
Yes.
We even take care of Pitt volleyball at times. So you got to get up to speed on that Facebook page that we just hit 2,081. And you're one of those likes too, so thank you.
Hey.
We do talk Pitt.
It's good to hear.
And you can talk Pitt right now. What's on your mind about Pitt?
Well, I want to say a good season. It wasn't the best. 6-6, I'll take it.
7-6.
7-6.
Yeah,
with
the bowl.
Big bowl.
Could you tell the folks at home where Tyrone Ezell, number 50, went to high school at?
Ty Ezell, number 50, Still Valley, Monroe, PA boy.
Where did you go to high school at?
Still Valley, Monroe, PA boy.
Hold it a second.
No
Smoking
more questions.
Jim's not here.
No gateway. No, this is a gateway free show.
Are we in a gateway free zone?
Gateway free zone today.
All right, we'll keep it that way, just in respect to a guy that's in the hospital.
Hey, yeah, we're just.
Hey, you know, hey, to get back to the Pitt thing, you know, the Pitt football team, you know, really kind of woke up in that bowl game against Bowling Green, and the thing I found interesting was the fact that Pitt was 5-point underdogs to Bowling Green.
5.5.
Well,
those guys that bet once in a while.
The people that made the biggest noise for the Pitt Panthers at the bowl game were freshmen.
That's right.
Which kind of gives us a reason to be optimistic for the upcoming season. But the question I have is, you know, the Pitt basketball team, they've only got one loss. But apparently they're not getting any respect around the country at all. They're still not even ranked in the top 25. And I believe they start their ACC season this weekend
coming up. January 4th against away, NC State.
Yeah. You know, and what's Pitt basketball got to do to get itself recognized?
Play somebody good and win? Against good opposition? They haven't played anybody yet.
I think they've had a soft early non-conference schedule, but it'll be a test those first four games before Syracuse, I think, if they can keep the pressure on defense that they have and the younger guards get the ball around and make opportunities. Zona's come around, I think. So, you know, I think they have a good chance.
The problem that I have, like, you know, and I have somewhat of this problem with college football, but more so with basketball, is, you know, I think it does the team a disservice and even the fans a disservice to play your first 12 or 13 games against really, like, subpar competition. I mean, you know, by all rights and concerns, they should be undefeated going into
what game did you go to?
I went to the Cal Poly game.
Excuse me, Cal ladies Poly. Of the Sisters of the Poor?
That's it. That's the one. Yeah. Okay. That's the one.
How'd you think Cal they U? Looked in that game?
Was that Cal U? Cal University?
No.
Don't bring that up.
Pretty easy win against a high school team, I'd say.
Who's one of the best freshmen that you've watched on a team? Do you have a
freshman? I don't have a freshman. I like Robinson. He's okay. Good. He's not too bad. Right. Patterson's my favorite on the team this year. Like Patterson, Zana, like the big guy. Wish we could have kept Adams.
Hey, he's made the millions and he's going all right.
Up with the Thunder.
He's doing good with the Thunder, but
issues and he had to provide for his family.
You know, it would have been nice to see him around for a year or two more, but
he's providing.
I think Dixon has that ability to, you know, whoever he has, make it happen. I don't see a CIBC championship this year for us.
BC?
No.
We'll be going to the big dance. We'll be back.
Really? Nice. We'll be back. Well, it seems like they do score a lot more points than the normal Pitt teams. Now, with the competition tightening up, that's where I'm a little.
ACC, run and gun, a lot of offense, not known too much for their defense. So I think Dixon knew that, and he's adjusted accordingly, and Brandon Knight has done a good job. And
the thing that was heartbreaking is in the one stadium that Pitt has been known to quote-unquote own, Madison Square Garden, the first time they went up there to play somebody, they got... they tripped and fell a little bit. Okay. And that's usually a place where they always recruited well and played well.
Who was that, the Bearcats?
Bearcats.
Cincinnati? Yeah.
Cincinnati. Low scoring game.
Yeah, very low.
Pause for a minute. Go Oregon. Ducks number one. Second team from Pitt.
That's your Stone Cold Lead Pipe lock for this evening?
It's my lead pipe. That's my lead pipe.
Lead cinch pipe.
Bet Ducks the house.
Fan. They have a player.
We're not trying to promote gambling.
They have a player on their team, number 11. His last name's Addison.
Therefore,
Braylon Addison, keep an eye out for him.
You know what? Now I know why I like you as the second Brenner on the team here. I go by all the players that have Allen. I like those players.
There you go. So,
especially on the Steelers. They seem to have a lot of them. So, at times.
All studs. All studs.
Just kidding. I'm not always a fan of those guys.
I think we could all agree that the Steelers are going golfing not for any other fault other than their own. You can't really blame the officiating at any facet, really. You know, Tomlin's antics kind of, you know, put the kibosh on the season. And they let a couple games slide where you let a team from the South come up and beat us at home in the Miami Dolphins. We should have had that one. We should have had the Vikings, you know. But
Steelers, all that what-if thing, just like their time management. What do you think of how the Steelers manage a clock there? And I've never asked you that question. But...
I like the no huddle. I think Ben has his most success with the no huddle. I think Haley and them realize that toward the end of the season. Let him call a few plays.
But that's not really the question. The question is in situational clock management, where we're trying to run the clock out like Coward was so good at doing, we're just not able to do it. You know, they're like playing mad in the wrong way.
Or you think it even matters?
Well, you know, and the thing is, you know, that they, you know, granted they made some pretty serious gaffes as far as clock management goes. In more than one game this year, but you know, if you look at the way the season went for them, you know, they got rid of a whole lot of veteran people, and they replaced them with a bunch of untested young guys, and it took them half the season to figure out what they were doing and to get the confidence in themselves. And you know, you got to give the coaching staff credit for sticking with them and not throwing in the towel on the year. I mean, they could have very easily tanked it this year and played for a draft pick, but that's just not the way that the Steelers organization does things.
I understand, but I can't give a lot of the coaches that credit because Big Ben is on the record as saying 99% of the plays are called by him in the no huddle. So I've never been a Haley fan. When they go to the Super Bowl with Haley sitting on the sidelines with the script and they don't use it, I'll be a fan.
Okay, but you know what? And as far as what Ben says, he also said that nothing happened in that restroom in Milledgeville. So, you know, I mean,
he's not,
you know,
he's not convicted. I'm not a Big Ben fan, as most people know. I appreciate that he's a stud on the field, and he's won us many a game that we shouldn't. But we did have some players step up. Like they only had, 7 sacks in the last 6 games.
And now with 2 different centers.
Yeah, and a 4-string center. We had Marcus Gilbert couldn't even stand up.
Yeah, he's terrible.
And how did we even gain any yardage and then Le'Veon Bell set a record.
That's the stud.
You know, when you look at this, and we had nothing but problems
with
the offensive
pit stop
line until they sat down Mike Adams. And once Mike Adams sat down and stopped playing on a regular basis, the line solidified. And actually, the Steelers actually had an offensive line at the end of the season that they didn't start the season with.
Well, I always think adversity builds character. And I think that's what we had, because these guys had nowhere else to go. There was nobody else to back them up. And maybe the coaches did light a fire under them a little bit, but they did play better, so I'm happy with that.
It's called heart.
Well, whatever it's called, some of them did step up, but a couple of them were so glaring in how they didn't. It was in spite of them because of the other guys.
Ben, his uniform wasn't getting dirty the last three or four games of the year. And that was the whole key to the success of the offense and the team. The defense started playing good football, started playing very sound. Players started right. Jason Worlds, for example. I never thought that he would do anything.
But he's an unrestricted free agent right now, so it's going to be interesting. They got 22 unrestricted free agents right now, as it stands. And I'm going to give you some names. We're going to go with Ryan Clark.
ESPN.
Yeah, he's going to be an announcer next year.
Jason Worlds.
Steeler.
He'll end up being franchised or something along that line, I'm sure of it.
Lamar Woodley might be back because he's a $14.8 million hit against the cap.
They're cutting him. They're not even going to use him because why do you want a guy that's 400 pounds, got the money, it's
over. Here's the thing with Lamar Woodley. If they get rid of him after the 1st of June, they only take like a $5 or $6 million cap hit on him. They don't take the full $14
million. Well, I don't care when they get rid of him. He's not going to play for the Steelers next year. They can't afford a guy whose hamstrings are shot when he first goes out in the field to practice.
His calf
blows up, you know, right after he tackles three guys. So
I'll tell you, really impressive.
What do you think, Addison? We got to get you in here, buddy.
Yeah, you know, Chip, I think the point you made about Pitt football program with a lot of young talent, it's going to be exciting. I think the Steelers have a lot of that, too. We saw that with Le'Veon Bell. Wheaton, wide receiver, up and coming. Jarvis Jones, took on the defense in the Browns game. I think he led with seven tackles.
Good point.
Coming into his own.
Another Allen.
So I think that Pittsburgh has a lot of bright
Cameron Hayward
bright spots.
He was playing lights out on the defensive line.
You know, it may be time to shift from the old veteran mentality and.
Oh, well, we're definitely getting away from Cowers players now, so we're going to see what Mike Tomlin and Kevin Colbert are made of, because their last, like, five drafts, in my opinion, have been subpar and lackluster.
You know what? I'm glad you're sitting in the smoking gym seat, because you haven't missed a beat. Addison, what else? Were you at the last game with the Steelers in the rain? Or?
I was not.
I didn't see any photos, so I sort of thought
not
that.
Not a fan of the rain. I stayed in the house and watched it.
Had a nice
enjoyed
view.
Enjoyed it. I was able to throw the remote when I wanted to and not have to worry about hitting anyone. So it was enjoyable. It was a good holiday.
Good.
Good sports holiday.
Well, it looks like you studied up. You told me you'd be prepared.
I'm always prepared.
You come in more prepared.
I'm glad.
You are the closer, buddy.
With a shark tank. You know,
welcome.
Call us in there and we're ready.
I know. You come straight out of the bullpen.
That's
you gulped down that last four bites that you had. So I know you're a Brenner because I've seen your brother. He bit one of my fingers off because I tried to grab that last fry.
And now we're talking resolutions. We have one. He's biting fingers off. So now he's.
I know. All protein, buddy. Meat. Oh, with a bone, too, there. So it hurts a little.
Yeah,
let me put it.
You got to get the marrow out of it, then.
It'll be good. Hey, you're welcome back anytime.
Absolutely. I appreciate it, guys.
Thank you for coming.
Pitt basketball, I have a lot to look forward to.
Yep.
2014.
Hey, go Marc-Andre Fleury.
Oh, we didn't get Penguin talk from you.
Go Zatkoff.
What'd you say?
Go Zatkoff.
Okay.
Who's Zatkoff?
Zatkoff.
Is he play for
Is that a
Penguins?
Brother of ours?
Yes.
Your younger brother. That's Zatkoff Brenner.
The only goalie I know in the Pittsburgh is Marc-Andre Fleury, number 29. Your favorite.
He is.
Is it? Oh,
on
we
got to
talk
day.
About that.
My favorite on opposite day.
Oh, man.
And when it was Brett Johnson, it was Ken Reagan. And it was,
so you're like a George Costanza type of guy. I'm teasing. You said it's opposite. You see that knockout punch? See, they keep me in boxing here. They usually beat me up pretty good. That was an easy one.
That was a good one.
Yeah.
But us Brenners, we like to set people up.
Do you? Well, I tried.
For the easy ones.
Yeah, thank you.
So, the layups. We're all about the layups.
You know what? I'm going to let you stay 2 more minutes with stuff like that. That was just great. No, get out of here. Thank you. Happy New Year.
Happy
it was
New
a
Year,
pleasure.
Guys. Pleasure as always.
Tell your growing fan base who you are and what university you're from.
Hi, I'm Mario Tempest from Tempesta University. thank you for having me on tonight. I appreciate it.
Were they on Pitt's basketball schedule this year?
Not this year.
Tempesta High School is.
Yeah, they weren't on there this year. But hey, thanks to you and your mom again. Cookies were delicious. Those hillbilly cookies are just, my son and I were wrestling over that one to get those cookies. He goes, what are these? Hillbilly cookies. Very good.
I do want to have a shout out for the mayor there. I want to bring up Pitt. I got to admit.
We're on a streak, 2 in a row.
Don't hurt me, but I'm not a big college football fan.
Okay.
I found myself sitting down and watching the whole entire Pitt football game the other night.
Yeah.
From beginning to end, and I'm so glad that I did because the youth, like you said, Chip, 3 freshmen stood out. They were very impressive, and there's a lot to look forward to in the future.
Yeah,
that running back was a beast, man. Collins, is that his
Connors.
Name?
James Connors. Yeah.
Man, what a beast! He was just.
We gotta give a shout out to Mr. Boyd, the Clayton Bear single A football product.
Tyler Boyd.
Yeah.
Tyler
that punt
Boyd.
Return was incredible.
James
man.
Connor broke a record that was set by Tony Dorsett.
Well, listen, Tony Dorsett broke that in the Sugar Bowl for a national title. So I don't want to get the Little Caesars Bowl in Detroit in front of 1,000 kids and the biggest stage to the biggest stage.
Hey, Zach, I got to agree with you, but they still won the Pizza Bowl. It wasn't the ABC XYZ Bowl.
Pizza Bowl or the Sugar Bowl. I mean, I'm going Sugar Bowl.
I agree with
playing
you.
Against Put an asterisk.
I'm glad you brought that up because one of the subjects I wanted to talk about was records. For instance, Bell broke Franco Harris's record.
Yes.
Does anybody remember that we used to play 12 games in a year? Then 14 and now 16. I think there should be a lot of asterisks involved with these bowl games, like
well,
you said,
if you want to hear
the number of games.
You want to hear an interesting fact. Le'Veon Bell broke Franco's Harris's record in one less game than Franco played in 1972.
I'll take that back. I appreciate
they,
that.
They, yeah, just, you know, Le'Veon Bell sat out for a couple of games this
That's
year.
That's true. Played, I forgot about that.
Yeah. Franco played 14, and Le'Veon Bell played in 13. So,
you're right. But the rest of them, you know, they're all.
What about Antonio Brown? Antonio Brown, he went 16 games with at least 5 catches and 50 yards
you know
for
what?
A whole season.
I'm glad you brought that up also. Who sits down and makes up these things? Who's
There's
thought?
What happens.
Apparently somebody that has no
50 yards, or was it 5 catches, 50 yards, and 16 games? Who sits down and makes these up?
But that's never happened in NFL history.
That's
ever.
Why.
But who,
that's
who,
why.
Who sat down and thought that up, though?
They have a bureau that records all these things, like the Elias Bureau in baseball. They record all of it.
I hope it's a computer and not a geek.
No, there's no computer.
It's a geek.
It's a geek without
statistician.
A computer. Yeah, they
it's
call
a
them statisticians.
Yes, a guru.
Now that we got that clarified, what else do you want to bring up?
Well, what I want to bring up is the new year's coming up.
Okay.
Everybody here hopefully will have a resolution. And if it has to do with health, I think I'll be able to help you out. If you want to exercise and lose weight, I can help you with that. Our product is being used, like I said before, by all the Olympians in the upcoming Winter Olympics. All the Olympians will be drinking our meal replacement shakes and eating our meal replacement bars. If you have problems sleeping and it affects your life, I can help you with that. If you have a problem with lack of energy, I can help you with that.
Well, Mario, when you say meal replacement, what do you mean by meal replacement?
Like, meal replacement is you can drink milkshakes that you don't necessarily got to drink these
so
to lose
like
weight.
So it's not like a bar? It's not like a bar?
Well, there's both. There's milkshakes and the bars that go with it. You can eat both if you like. Because what happens is people drink these meal replacement shakes, but they got a habit of eating snacks. So you want to eat something good. Not a French fry, you want to eat a meal replacement bar. So for people that can't just drink shakes,
Well, you, I know you've brought the drinks, like the more like sports kind of drinks, like the Red Bull kind of drink, but I haven't seen the
shake or
the
bar. No, he brought a sleep drink here.
I would bring the shakes
in. Is it powderized or is it already?
It's powder.
You have to mix it up?
You can mix it with either milk or water. It tastes good with even water, believe it or not. And then our juices, of course, is what the Houston Rockets, Utah Jazz.
Could the Steelers get Aaron Donald?
We'll hold that under protest here.
Breaking news. Will the Steelers get Aaron Donald?
No. He's not going to last that long.
Probably not.
He's not going
to
last that long.
Oh, we'll have to call Smoking Jim. Let me text him.
See, Smoking Jim doesn't even have him on his draft board.
No, he's not.
He's not gonna be good.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
He's not gonna last that long.
And back to your protein and meal replacements.
Sochi.
Anyhow, if you'd like to research that, you go on my website, mymonavie.com/Mario's Juice. Okay. Well, what are you gonna say?
Mario's got the juice.
No, I was gonna say, I think you're in some magazine.
Yeah, I'm in his classy magazine.
You saw this magazine yet? Pittsburgh Sportsline magazine. And then if you go to page lucky number 7, well,
right on the other side of Smoking Jim's top 30.
On the other side of the top 5 gateway players in the country. Mona V.
That's right.
It's all right here. Here's Mr. Mona V out of Pittsburgh. If you don't get a hold of Mario, you're not going to be healthy this year. Just call him.
Thank you, Alan.
We appreciate you. Happy New Year to you.
Same to you.
Thanks for being a friend and a fan of the show.
Zach, you did a fine job filling in.
Chip, I always kick it off to you with what we might have missed on what's on our mind. We'll just talk a little halftime sports here, buddy. And we got little Z. I know he's got a lot on his mind because he only talked about one thing. So I'm getting nervous now. He's ready to unleash. Go ahead.
Hey, Alan, down for halftime here. You know, today is what is known as Black Monday. What is Black Monday? Black Monday is the first Monday after the completion of the NFL season, and that's when the axe starts to swing. And 5 coaches lost their jobs today. The Tampa Bay Bucks fired their coach. The Vikings fired theirs. The
Lions, Browns.
Browns fired their coach.
Texans.
The Lions fired their coach. The Texans
Lions
fired
and Tigers.
Their coach. But, you know, and the axe is not finished swinging yet. I do believe.
Oh, the Redskins?
The Redskins. Mike Shanahan's
gone. How could that be?
And, you know, and here's the thing. You know, the Redskins, they played so well this year that they earned the second pick in the NFL draft for the St. Louis Rams. So that just shows you why the Redskins are doomed to be consistent losers, the same way the Cowboys are. And if I wasn't, the best thing I've seen all weekend was watching the Cowboys blow it again in the last game of the season. They don't need Tony Romo to blow a game.
Good. I'm glad all those haters.
Put in his quarterback. As long as Jerry's running the show, they will come in and looking miserable. But
good point about Romo. All those people that hate Romo, they can still hate him, especially out of Pittsburgh, and laugh at him. But the Dallas Cowboys lost without him. So
listen,
it's
the
a
Dallas
good day
Cowboys
in Pittsburgh. Go ahead,
had Roger Staubach, they had Troy Aikman, and then they had Tony Romo. So
yeah.
You know, Tony Romo couldn't carry the groceries for either one of those two guys in the league. So I think it was good for Tony Romo to get to be injured and get to say, look, it wasn't me this time, but the results are still the same. So it's just funny to me how you have a $600 million stadium with a $100 million screen.
That's a billion dollar stadium.
$1 billion stadium, and you can't
largest
get
TV
the best quarterback
in the world.
You can't get a better quarterback to run your team.
They got $90 million tied up in Tony Romo because Jerry the genius knows better than the rest of us.
Little Z, what's on your mind?
Well, I mean, we could continue on with what Chip said. I mean, I enjoyed every minute of watching the Cowboys' demise.
You watch a whole game.
Oh, yeah. After the debacle that happened in Kansas City, where I became a Chiefs fan for a brief moment of four quarters.
I heard you lost the TV out the window after that.
It's actually mounted to the wall, or
okay.
I would have lost it.
Okay.
So it was
well,
too much to take it off.
But, hey, you know what? We're on halftime. Hey, Steelers fans, the Chiefs will be coming to Pittsburgh this fall.
Yeah, the schedule's out already.
I can't wait to see Sucko.
I'll just tell you, my prediction right now is 11-5 because it's just as easy a schedule as this past year. So I know they're not rebuilding. They're winners. And I'm not being sarcastic. 11-5. I'll predict it now.
I think it depends on what they do in the draft.
I don't care what they do.
Well, I got you guys here. What's your Super Bowl predictions for the Super Bowl right now as it stands?
Right now as it stands. The way it's looking to me right now, I'm looking for Seattle and Denver to end up in the Super Bowl with Seattle winning it all.
Al Levine.
Ditto. I told you on the phone earlier today, don't ask me that question because it's Seattle and Denver.
Well, I'm going to differentiate a little bit from these two. I'm going to go with Seattle, but I'm going to go when it comes down to Brady and Manning for the right to go to the Super Bowl. I'm going Tom Brady in the cold.
I like Brady.
I like the genius. He videotapes people, not Bruce Arians, the genius that didn't make the playoffs. That was, 10-5? And didn't make 10-6?
Ten and six
and didn't make the playoffs. The Steelers at 8-8.
By 3 points.
Almost won. Only 3 points.
Yeah.
You know, so he'll get an award. He'll get a Coach of the Year award or something like that. But
Maybe two. He might get two this year.
I'd rather be playing in New Jersey for the Lombardi Trophy.
Good points, Z.
Me
I'm not going to argue with that, but I disagree. Denver's winning it all this year.
Really?
And Jersey. Denver and Jersey this year.
I think
a snowstorm.
The difference between Denver and Seattle is the strength of their defense. Seattle's just got a stronger defense, and Manning can be had.
I know he can be had, but that stem cell surgery that he had has been successful. He's played in the cold in Denver, and it gets pretty cold and windy up there in Colorado. So I think when the weather gets bad in Jersey, that's going to be the edge. Plus him throwing 4 touchdown passes.
Hey, there you go.
Just for argument's sake.
There you go.
That's what our opinions. These are all opinions there.
Yeah.
And we haven't talked enough Penguins, so we're on the halftime show. I'd like to at least get a little Penguin talk. Z, I know you're a big fan of the Penguins and number 2-9er. The new 2-9er, not the old 2-9er.
The best 2-9er right now for the pipes for the Penguins.
Your brother, just that nice meal he had, it's no longer in him.
I know, he's a Zatkoff fan, but...
What'd you call him again?
One of my mom's favorite players just blew out his knee, and he looks to be done for the season, Pasquale Dupuis. So I want to wish Dupuis a healthy road back, but the key to the Penguins is the man behind the pipes, and that's Marc-Andre Fleury. As he goes, we go. So you'll see, as long as he has a big May and an even bigger June, we might be holding Lord Stanley's Cup again, so...
I know, yeah. Your brother has just left the building. That isn't Elvis. It's Addison. He's out of the building. Mom, bring him back.
He
Lois.
Could be out of the building. We wouldn't have won the Stanley Cup against the Red Wings if it wasn't for Marc-Andre Fleury.
Hold it. You guys fight in the Brenner household or all through Munhall and Homestead because I'm going to announce that fight. Believe me.
But, you know, getting back to the Penguins, you know, not many people realize that the Penguins actually played last night. James Neal put up a hat trick against the Columbus Blue Jackets.
5 points he had.
So,
all five points.
You lose a goal scorer like Pasquale Dupuis, who's probably skating on the number one line in hockey with Crosby and Kunitz. The Penguins just seem to find a way to keep winning. It doesn't matter who goes down, whether it's Sid, Evgeny Malkin, now Dupuis down. Their whole defensive squad has been on the injured reserve list for how long, but they seem to find
good
a way
to see
win.
That young Samuels step up. Ulf's,
well, I want to give out a phrase that I hope you don't laugh. We haven't heard it with the Steelers, but it's truly the standard is the standard with the Penguins because we've had players that they're not coming back this year from Vokoun and everybody else.
You don't think Vokoun can be back?
No,
sometime?
I don't think he can come back and take the risk.
I think the thing with Thomas Vokoun is that he's played hockey for a lot of years. He's made his money. He wants to enjoy his family. He's got young children, and you know what?
The risk.
Being there for his family is more important to him than hockey.
So what you've seen from Zatkoff, you don't think Ray Shero needs to go out there and make a move and bring in a veteran goaltender in case Fleury has a potential meltdown?
Shero, I trust his judgment, and I know he's out there looking because Zatkoff is really unproven. He's done very well, don't get me wrong. He's had a lot of great support and some timely goals, too. And, you know, that's helped, too. If you get the scoring... Well, it can overcome a few of the soft goals that get in.
Well, to speak to Zach's point, like, say, for example, you know, that we do have to rely on Zatkoff. I think the changes that the Penguins made in the style of game that they were playing, they went from, you know, a 2-2-1 configuration to a 1-3-1, and what that's done is it shut down the center ice of the long outlet passes, which right. was leading to a lot of odd man rushes. You're seeing better team defense all the way around, which is what I believe is making Marc-Andre Fleury a better goaltender. And you know, regardless of who's in the pipe, you know, you're going to have a better result.
It cuts down on a lot of those chances that we were talking about in the past. How Bosma has a system and he won't vary from it. So he did change.
Hey, let me ask you this, though. In the playoffs, though.
Yeah.
The goalie is responsible for stopping the goals. He doesn't score the goals. So when they go and they you know, make these other goalies look like the best goalie of the year, you know, it doesn't matter who's behind the pipes. He can't score. They have to score.
Right,
so they have to show up, too.
But here's the other problem. If the confidence of your goaltender is shot because of those things, you have to make a change. Now, the offense did leave us, like I said, they had a power outage during the playoffs. I don't want to use that phrase anymore. There should not be a power outage.
At console.
Believe me, never at console. Look at this year. How do they have the best record at console energy? Because the power is on, okay? That's how simple it is. You're a contractor, best young contractor in the area. You can see me post that on Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. A couple of our fans were getting weak, so I thought they need a little boost there with all this conversation. We're going to end the halftime show, and we're going to bring up another guest right now.
A lot of pressure on me here today because you guys actually are conducting a sports talk show in which you're talking about Pitt basketball and hockey and football.
Breathe.
It's always a great...
They taught me this in boxing. Just keep breathing.
Go faster than that.
No, he's a good man. I don't want to knock him out. He's getting dizzy. Look at him.
But it's always good to have a lot of different variety in your guests and whatnot, but then when you have to pull a guy off the street like me, growing a bad beard in the wintertime, you know.
Terrible beard. Hold it, but I just want to interrupt this program for an update. Tom, you don't have to ask anymore. You will fill in tomorrow for Smoke and Jim on our Tuesday studio show. Okay?
All right. Thank you.
And by the way, Tom, I read your article about Pittsburgh Sportsline, and thank you very much. Said some very kind things about all of us. Great article.
Well, you're certainly welcome. It was something because of the award ceremony that I went with Al on Friday, once again filling in for. I can't fill the shoes of Smoking Jim Frazier, but
let me just tell you, geez, that chest is weak. Come on now,
can you eat a meatball hoagie?
I usually can. I had the best
meatball
hoagie I had in my
Jim
life
Frazier,
2 weeks
no
ago, right, Mario? Anyways,
2 weeks ago.
2 weeks ago. And
thanks,
also,
Trapper Tom.
Also, Al, you mentioned about reading two books with Brandy when she was on with the pre-show.
Not with Brandy. I want to clarify. I was not with Brandy.
You were talking
I read
with
them on
Brandy.
My own.
Talking with Brandy about the
books. You could only be
books.
So lucky.
Is one of those books the Zach Needs Exercise books, or is that the size of the books that...
what Jim Frazier writes.
Mine are about this big, and they're like quadruple that size.
Okay,
here, you can read the first page.
There we are.
Get out of there. Give me that pound. That's Brenner's top. Okay, how'd I do on that one?
That was good.
Okay.
That was good.
What else do you have?
But yeah, you guys are did a lot of talk about Pitt basketball, like we said. I think you mentioned volleyball, Pitt
yes,
volleyball.
Yes, I did. I did do that.
All that stuff going on. Over the weekend, of course, UFC... They had the big fight over the weekend.
You're not going to mention Silva.
How can you not mention Silva?
If you looked on Pittsburgh Sports Line on Facebook,
let's
you saw the photo.
Let's go to the clip.
You
right.
saw the photo.
One day we're going to have the capabilities to pull up and show a clip like that.
You know what? I'm actually working on some of that. I do have some coming attractions. They'll be for 2014. I was just in some talks with a couple... much smarter people than myself that are definitely more geekish than I'll ever be. So there may be some other capabilities that come out of this.
But the Silva fight where he broke his, reminiscent of an old wrestling
you saw
injury.
That. Yeah, you saw, from, I saw about Psycho Sid Vicious.
Psycho Sid Vicious, 6'9", real spindly legs.
Against Steiner.
It was your article that mentioned a deficiency in vitamin D.
Yeah, vitamin D3, folks. Make sure you take your D3, drink green tea, keeps you healthy.
Do you have that, Mario? Do you have it in your, in your magic syrup?
That's why I'm all about Mona V. With that's Mario.
Right. That's right. But yeah, Sid Vicious on WCW television live. Or maybe it was a pay-per-view. It was live.
I think it was pay-per-view,
saw
it, if I'm honest.
And
Scott Steiner.
Scott Steiner, Road Warrior Animal, and a couple of other guys, Psycho Sid Vicious, on the second rope, probably no higher than this table, jumped off of there and snapped his shin.
Have you ever been on that first rung like that?
Oh, yeah.
Because I know you're a wrestler. We don't talk much about it. Enough about all this name dropping there.
but that was a horrific accident.
What about
injury on live television?
John Theismann's leg getting trapped.
Yeah, I saw that too. Yeah, I saw
Lawrence Taylor. That was one of the most.
You were just a young kid back then.
Yeah, but I watched
I've
it.
Ever seen.
And speaking of hurt injuries in wrestling, where were you when Owen Hart fell from the ceiling?
I just heard about it. I didn't see it live.
He was
too good.
I had it on pay-per-view.
Oh,
that
did you
night.
Really?
And what they did was they didn't show that. They went to
they just like
screen.
Yeah, they like showed the ceiling or stared out into the crowd
they,
or something.
They just broke away and then they continued the show.
Yeah.
But they went to a black screen because
for the folks watching that don't know, Owen Hart did a gimmick where he would fall from the ceiling from the rafter and he would have a rope. Well, they tied it wrong, and he went down and he met his maker.
He hit his head against the top rope and it snapped his neck.
Yeah, I didn't want to go into too much detail on that.
This is a family show, but there are bad things that happen in life.
Hey, that just goes to show. Hey, wrestling isn't studio wrestling isn't
It's not
the safest.
Whatever you tell me, it's
gig.
Not staged, I've been
not
told.
Staged. It's not staged.
And when you're 369 pounds and 3% body fat, you
right.
know
Mr.
That it's
Puniverse
not staged.
Bob Atlas?
Yes. The legend in my mind.
We talked about this when the Undertaker threw Mick Foley off the top of the cage.
Here in Pittsburgh, yeah, that's right.
That was a great moment in wrestling, too.
To tell him that it was fake.
Yeah.
And speaking
of
wrestling.
Cactus Jack, Mick Foley is a legend, as you're well aware.
Oh, absolutely.
And, he's fought overseas.
You're talking to the legendary Trapper Tom with the KSWA Wrestling. Out of Lawrenceville, you got to check them out there.
Well, thank you very much
for
the plug.
When's your first show of the new year?
It's January 11th, Battle Bowl.
Battle Bowl.
That's our Over the Top Rope. That's a Saturday night.
Over the Top Rope Battle Royal.
Over the Top Rope Battle Royal and three different title shots are on the line.
We may have to show up there to see what you do.
Is there any slots open left in the lineup?
I'm his manager. Can you take care of little Z?
Also, it should be... In wrestling, it should be noted that ROH, Ring of Honor Wrestling, you can see that on cable television. They're going to be here at the David L. Lawrence Convention Center on January 25th.
What day is that?
That's a Saturday.
Again.
And they're going to be there on Saturday, and then the following day.
Are you going to be there?
Never say never.
Never. I knew I could do it.
As soon as you talk about the other alliances, man, you throw him for a loop.
Yeah. Finally got it in.
What other alliances?
Happy New Year.
What other alliances? There's only one. But then on January 26th.
I'm excited about 2014 wrestling.
January 26th.
I got him, folks. He can't even talk. The silver tongued devil with the silver beard.
Hey,
he's
you're
done.
Up against the talking machine.
Yeah, undefeated.
A 10-minute conversation turns into an hour.
Undefeated this year. Go ahead.
The 26th, of course, WWE with the second biggest event of their calendar season,
the Royal Rumble, which is also at Console Energy Center. The winner of that ultimately headlines
WrestleMania.
Yes.
That I will be at. My son and I have tickets
already,
and there's a lot of. I think it's sold out.
That's what I heard. That's why I was wondering.
They always do.
They always sell out. As everybody knows, Pittsburgh is a
wrestling town.
A terrific wrestling town, and that's the biggest. That's the second biggest event of the year for the WWE because there's returning people that maybe had been injured come back. and there's always speculation as to who the special guests, you know, the surprise attendants are going to be. You know, whether it's going to be Terry Bollea, you never know.
Yes.
And Terry Bollea, for those who don't know, that's Hulk Hogan.
Is Hulk Hogan, who's a free agent out there. And also what I would like to personally see
No more Bret Hart.
It might be Jake the Snake Roberts, because Jake the Snake Roberts, who I saw in a Moundsville, West Virginia locker room in 2007, and he and
this is a family show.
This doesn't tell tales out of school.
Okay.
More drunk higher than anybody I've ever seen in my life.
Really?
Period.
Even more than Razor Ramon.
Period.
You know, and I'll tell you something. I saw in a documentary about Jake Roberts.
Yeah.
And he had fallen onto some very, very bad times.
Yeah.
If he got himself turned around, that really would be a
that
story
has been
of
a goal.
Year.
That Kevin has knows. Been a goal for him ever since he moved into the house with Diamond Dallas Page in Atlanta.
Yep.
Staying clean, DDP. Trying to get himself in decent shape. His goal early on, his goal early on was to be in the Royal Rumble in January. And as a guy that if he stays clean and he stays sober, and if his music hits at Console Energy Center, you're going to hear it here.
Really?
Because people will, they want to love
the first WrestleMania. We watched the first one down at the Civic Arena. The second one they had it closed circuit down at the Syria Mosque.
Mm-hmm.
And there were people down there dressed up like Jake the Snake Roberts. It's one of the funniest things I've ever seen. I'll tell you about it after the show.
But yeah, he was, if he is able to stay clean, if he's able to stay healthy, it would be terrific to see him, and there's always a couple of surprises, people from the past that show up. Maybe
are you on the inside? Do you get the scoop there from all these guys you know?
I ain't saying nothing.
That's right. We don't give up our sources.
Listen, he doesn't want to go up against Vince McMahon either. Vince McMahon is ruthless.
I keep trying. I'm an investigative reporter tonight. Look, I stymied him. One shot. First time. That's because I'm trying to help you out for tomorrow night when we get ready to rumble in the studio.
Yeah, that's my ring, folks.
That's Chip's ring. It's Z's ring. It's Smoking Jim. I'm just along for the ride on that show.
He's just the moderator.
If I can throw out a shameless plug.
Please do.
Check out the Valley Mirror. It's a weekly newspaper out of Munhall, Pennsylvania. I have a
hold it. The Brunners are doing giving standing ovations. I better clap.
It is a community newspaper that comes out once a week, and I have
whose articles in there.
My article on Bucky Palermo entering the KSWA Hall of
Fame. No way, the legendary referee.
The legendary referee.
And Alan has they were kind enough referees.
Yeah, yeah.
They were kind enough to print it for me, so that's good. So please pick that up at your local newsstands. It only costs you half a buck. And
In the issue of Pittsburgh Sportsline, who did you write about the old-time local wrestler?
Dominic DiNucci.
Dominic DiNucci. When I was at Roberto's Auto Body on Saturday, I gave him a copy of the magazine. The first thing he's saying, he's like, oh, I know Dominic DiNucci.
Here's so a it's shameless a small promotion. World. Wait, magazine.
Yeah. Now, Zach.
Trapper
also,
Tom.
Also, Zach.
Great article.
Who did Dominic DiNucci train?
George the Animal Steel.
A couple of decades earlier.
A couple decades earlier?
No. Bruno, he said. Somebody said Bruno.
Before Bruno.
Now, who did Dominic DiNucci train in the wrestling game?
Who's on his lifeline on the Brunner team? Dun, dun.
Can I get a Google?
Bing. Bing it.
You think Bing's better than Google, Alameen?
I've heard it is. I how use about, Google.
How about Pittsburgh's own Shane Douglas?
Whoa.
Oh, Shane Douglas.
I knew he was pulling an ace out.
And Shane. Mrs. Foley's favorite boy, Michael.
Nick. Yeah.
What about Shane Douglas? I heard he was a real piece of work locally in his time as a human being to work with.
I didn't work with him at those times. I've worked with him several times, and it was
so he's humbled now.
Over the last couple of years, he's nothing but a class act when I've seen him. In fact, we had the Paul Shulo Memorial Show a couple of years ago, and he headlined that show for us.
With the officers.
Yeah, one of the three police officers that died in that shootout.
One of the three that got shot.
Yeah.
Brighton Heights.
Yeah. So, but yeah, he's I've been on a couple of shows with him. There was a fundraiser for the Shriners up in Cheswick, and he and Bubba the Bulldog had a no DQ, falls anywhere match. That was pretty cool.
I'll bet.
As well.
That
was
exciting.
That was a good match. That was a good match. A
lot of action.
But actually, Shane Douglas was just in my dad's neck of the woods over the weekend, Lancaster County, did a show down there. So, and they had Extreme Rising. For some reason, Shane Douglas wasn't on that card, even though he was one of the founders. He wasn't on that card.
Maybe he didn't get the email.
Maybe he didn't get
that
the
email. That happens in this
Maybe
day
he didn't
age.
Get the Facebook invite.
Well, you got to write an article because you're everywhere. If you want to read any great articles, this guy covers it, not just because he talks about us in a nice way, of course, but he does report on a lot of things
Thank
in the
you
community.
Very much.
I follow your stuff. We got to come up with some Facebook page that's better than what you have there, buddy, to get you promoting.
Yeah, there you go.
Al Levine and the Geeks.
Al will get you up to 2,500.
Yeah, but it won't get you. It won't get you up in his
I'm
phone.
I'm dangerous. They told me no smartphone yet. I'm staying dumb. It's working out pretty well.
You know what? He doesn't have a smartphone, but anytime you call that thing, he will answer it.
You may not like the answer you get on the phone. I will answer. No doubt. What else do you got on your mind? You covered some of the stuff you wanted to. You got some shameless promotion in, like we promote. So, where else are you? What's on your agenda for the New Year's?
I heard
there might be something happening in Lawrenceville for New Year's Eve.
Well, New Year's Eve.
What a guess.
At the Moose, the Lawrenceville Moose, have a little get-together down there. Anybody who sees this, I probably am not going to see this before the new year.
No,
though.
No, you could just say what a nice time it is there, and next year they can look at it.
So, ask me any questions. Hit me up on Facebook. Ask me any questions about the Lawrenceville Moose.
I've been there.
I'm the governor of the Lawrenceville Moose in 2013-14, so
how does somebody get to join the Moose? Who do they contact to join the Moose?
They check me out on Facebook.
How do they get a hold of you?
The head moose.
The big moose.
The big moose.
You know what? Don't use it all up, folks. You'll be seeing this show after it. So anything that happens tomorrow night, New Year's Eve show, he already gave you a preview of it. So it's not going to happen. It'll be a review.
I will wear a suit tomorrow.
Good for you.
I'm glad this isn't Trapper Tom.
Obviously.
Just because of that, I'm going to take a bath.
I'm going to shave my beard.
I guess I might as well chime in. I'm going to do what I normally do.
Go see Marianne at Azazu. She hit you with the Flobee.
It's tomorrow. Now, I think I got to get 3 hairs cut out of the left side. See,
Marianne, man, please give him a haircut.
Is that nice? Marion Workman, every Tuesday, Azazu downtown.
Every Tuesday?
It got all quiet in here. As soon as we started talking about your hair, it got super quiet.
The people were taking notes.
Yeah, well.
It must be the hair.
Well, you know what? On that happy note, we're going to have to end this show. I got a couple things to say. Thanks to Chip and Prophet Hainer for being on the show. Little Z, Zach Brenner, thank you for being on the show. Tom, the Trapper Liturgy, thanks for being on the show. I'm Al Levine, the Talking Machine, and I'm thankful, and I hope you have a safe new year and a happy new year. Thanks to everybody at BPTV. Thanks for the awards.
Dave Cable.
Things that I've won. Dave Cable, Devin Shea, Aaron Ward, the Tiger Kiger,
John,
Matt Harkins, Joe Natale. Who else did I met?
Did you mention Devin Shea?
Twice, Devin Shea. Devin Shea actually won an award.
Chris.
He was the greatest
George.
Volunteer of all time. 100 shows.
Hey.
Chris Satter. I forgot about Chris Satter. He
John.
Long I mentioned him 3 times.
Hey, he won an award too.
What about Jim Frazier? Get well soon, my friend.
That's right.
That's a given. We prayed for him early. Pray for him again. Smoking Jim, speedy recovery. Happy New Year. Thanks for watching.